If you're looking for a clean way to help onboard your new employees to your process, you are going to love this video. We're going to be breaking down this problem using a couple of different software, namely Airtable and Guidde, in order to show you how you can put together a library for your standard operating procedures and make onboarding that much easier for your new hires. If learning more about this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. We make it our mission to help you unlock your full potential using no-code tools. And one of our favorite no-code tools that we've been using for a long time is Airtable, but today, for the first time in this video, we're going to be taking a look at Guidde and including these two tools together so that you can do more with less resources. That is the name of the game here, maximizing efficiency. But before we hop into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're new to no code, you are going to love this free training that I've put together all about automation so that you can remove yourself from those automated processes that are just like copy paste, mundane repetitiveness. Do all that in the background so that you can focus on the big picture. I break it down for you in my training that you can grab at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Go ahead and sign up there for free and get immediate access. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. And what I'm doing right now is I've just put together a very, very high level Airtable solution. I've used the Airtable AI Builder to create this, and it's just for project management. I've got projects, clients, and contacts. First, we're going to go and take a look at the back end here. We're going to go to view data because I'm here in an interface on my previous screen. And you can see that I've got these three different components: projects as they relate to clients. And of course, clients are also connected to the contacts as well as projects. So we see that all of this data is interrelated. Now, flipping back into our interface, presumably this is what we would share with our employees and our staff so that people have a place to work from. So maybe our team knows how to use this tool inside and out because they've been living in this software for years or even longer. But what happens when we bring on new people? How do they know where to go, how to do what they need to do? We can put together an onboarding process for them, a little bit of micro training so that as they are joining the team, they have a resource to fall back on. Not only that, but they would have continual access to this resource so that they can go at any time if they forgot what they learned in training, just open it up, take 5 or fewer minutes to figure out what's going on, and then immediately be able to jump right back into their work and get going again. This is what we're going to build. So first we need to have our actual tool that we use. And then the second part that we need is Guidde. Guidde is an amazing software that allows us to create all kinds of resources for our team. And as you can see on the screen in front of me, their home screen, they're talking about offering things for FAQs, feature notes, onboarding, SAPs, how-to guides, anything that you need to create for your team as a resource so that they know how to do the thing that you need them to do. That is what Guidde is going to help us do, and it's going to make it so easy for you. No longer do you have to go in and take a bunch of different screenshots of things and write up complicated notes. All of that work is going to be done in the background on Guidde. Now, I do want to point out that they have a few different options. They do have a free option here that allows you to get started in the software, and then you can start paying for upgraded memberships as well. And I'm going to be highlighting some of these key features in our video here that you would get on the business plan. But if you want to get started for free, please do that. And also note that their business plan does include a 14-day free trial. Now, in order to use Guidde with our Airtable software, the first thing I want to do is actually create a place where I can store these assets that we're creating. So what I'm going to do is actually go back to my data in Airtable, and I'm going to create a new table, and I'm going to call it from scratch. I'll call it SOPs or just Guides. And I'm going to spell it D-D-E-S because Guidde with two D's is how we spell Guidde the software. And so right here, I can come up with, I mean, this is very simple. I'm going to delete my original fields that are created here by default, and I'll just have the name of the different things. So maybe one of them is adding a new client. And maybe one of these is adding a new contact. And you get the idea. Everything I'm doing here is just recording the different processes that the new people on my team are going to have to go through. Now, what I want to add, of course, is a URL. So the actual link for this thing is going to be a URL field, and you'll see why I want this in a moment. Now, I'm going to go back to my interfaces, and I'm going to add a new interface. I'm going to go into edit the interface itself, and I'm going to add an interface. We're going to call this onboarding. Or SOPs or something along those lines. There we go. And we'll go ahead and click next. And we're gonna do a record review. So what this allows us to do is basically say we're gonna have a list of records on one side. And then when people click on a particular record, they're gonna see information about that record. Specifically, what we want is for people on our team to look at our different guides, and maybe we'll sort these in alphabetical order by name. And let's click next. So when somebody's looking for something, and let's just call this guides, finish. When somebody's looking for something, they'll be able to come into this whole guide and see like, oh, look, here's adding a new client. Oh, here's adding a new contact. Super, super simple. All right. Now that we have this information, let's publish this. And now for guide. We want our first one to be all about how to add a new client. This is how easy this is. To start, I've installed Guidde in my Chrome browser. They have an extension. If you want to go ahead and get set up, go ahead and do that. And all I have to do is go up to my browser extension and I click it. And you see that it opens up this little window here and it says Guidde, create how-to videos. When I'm ready, all I have to do is click capture. Now, what am I capturing? Well, for us, I'm going to do an onboarding. Let's see if I can find it. Customer onboarding, could be internal onboarding, any kind of onboarding process that you have. And now we're going to put together the description of what it is we're doing. And for us, we're going to add a new either contact or client. We can pick. I'll go with contact here. Once we're happy, also make sure we select our language and we click go. Now the capture is about to start. We're going to get a little bit of a countdown here. We're going. Now we're live. Everything I click on the background is going to be captured by Guidde as we move through this process. So for us, we're adding a contact. I click on contacts. I click on add contact. I can add a name. Maybe I call this sample. And I'll just put in any old email. I'll use mine for this. I'll use a fake phone number. We could add a profile photo or not. We could associate this with a client or not. We could associate with projects and or team members, and we will create. That's the end of our process. And so all we have to do now is in the bottom, we just hover over in the bottom left corner over the Guidde icon, and we say that we're done. This is done. Now Guidde is doing the thinking on the back end. Now I'm going to keep this running without any edits as much as possible so that you can see how quickly all of this comes together. So here we go. It's already put all of these elements together. You can see that it's saving the graphics on the back end, and it's put together everything that I've clicked as I went through the process of adding a contact. So this now becomes such an easily referenced thing that we can share either externally or internally so that people know how to go about taking the next step that they need to take to do the action that we had set for them. So in this case, it would be like add contact. Then you click here, you can see that it's highlighted every step of the way. This is also putting together a video, as I mentioned, that we can watch. We can even include closed captions, and it has all of the elements here, but they've used all of this information. They've captured it all just by recording my screen and breaking it down step by step. Now, one thing is, you know, it's filling out the exact information that I filled out here, right? So I put in a fake phone number, but of course we don't want them to put in this number every time. Note that this is editable, and we can come in and say fill with the contact's phone number if applicable. So you see, we can edit these steps as well. It's going to save us a lot of time to have that AI bot on the background creating this for us, but of course, if we need to go in and make changes, we have that capability. Now, the reason that I built what I did on the back end is because we can also share this video. So here it is. I've taken my link and I can just share it. Anyone with the link can view it, or I can limit it to only people inside my organization or restrict it even further. Note that I can share this with an email address as well, but for our purpose, I'm going to copy this link and I'm going to head back into my Airtable data. So here I am again. I'm in my interface, but I'll go to my data itself into my guide, and I now have a URL link for the guide that we just created that shows us how to add a contact. Now my users back here inside of my interface, when they go through and they look at the guide, they can say, how do I add a contact again? I don't remember. They just click it. They open this up. It'll take them to the guide. It says, hey, you're leaving Airtable. No problem. We could embed this as well. There's so many different options to the things that we could do with these links, but now they have one click opportunity to go in and access this information. Now, as I mentioned, there are a couple of premium features on the paying plans for Guidde that I really want to dive into. The first of those is text to voice. So we did not capture our actual voice when we recorded the Guidde. You can see, though, that a summary was created, and it basically outlines what we did. It says this guide will walk you through the process of adding a new contact. By following these clear and concise constructions, you can effectively organize blah, 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 blah. So check this out. We're going to play the video just a second. You can hear the text to voice on the background.
This guide will walk you through the process of adding a new contact in Airtable.
So this is a great opportunity for us to, again, save even more time, and our end users are going to have an easier time adopting the process that we've laid out for them because they can watch the video as we displayed here or just go through the different components. Note that they can also jump to specific parts of the video if they wanted to see the introduction.
By following these clear and concise instructions.
And so just like that, we're able to help people navigate more quickly to the answer that they're looking for at the exact moment in time that they need it. If we need to make any adjustments, of course, we can also go in to edit the video as I've done here. Here's our text to voice. You can see exactly what it's going to read through and put on the screen. And we can also edit the text right here if we want to. Now, another amazing feature is we can update the pronunciation of words. So oftentimes when we're using certain words in tech, especially, they get pronounced incorrectly all the time. So for example, the word here, Airtable, do they say it correctly? Let's find out. We can put in alternative spellings here or enter IPA, which stands for International Phonetic Alphabet. That way we can basically train this software to know how to pronounce the words that we use commonly inside of our organization. In this case, just to be extra clear, maybe I would spell Airtable as two separate words and put in some alternate spelling here. And I could also add it to my workspace dictionary to make sure that in the future, if other people are using the same software in their videos, well, I don't have to worry about it every time. We can play the pronunciation. And there it is. Perfect. It's saying the word correctly, and I don't have to worry about it. But should we ever want to make changes in the future, we can always come back and do it right here. Click apply, and our changes have been saved. Sometimes we might want to add an interactive action step to our video. Let's say, for example, when somebody's watching this, we want to say, hey, you're watching the video and maybe you just want to click here and it's going to add that element of interactivity right there. Well, we can do that inside of our videos. Again, here I am in Guidde. I'm editing the video and I come in down here to say insert, and I can insert a single action or multiple actions. So what do we do here? We add an action, in this case, in our cover step, and we can say, learn more, for example. Where do we want them to go? Well, when they click here, we can send them to another step inside the process. We can send them to a different video entirely, or we can have them open up an external link. So maybe I want them to visit our website. I just drop it in like that, and you can see that we have a little pop-up that's going to come up with the description that we assigned, in the position that we assigned here. So lower right, upper left, wherever we want this pop-up to show up. And now we've enabled that and we can apply it. So now when somebody's accessing this, you can see that it has an interactive button here, an extra element. And when they click that, if they choose to, it's going to take them wherever we directed them to go. The last upgraded feature that I love is the brand kit. So we can come into our brand kit and actually update a lot of the default settings. We can add an intro video. We can add a default cover. Maybe it includes our company logo, our company colors, etc. We can also update the default endings, right? So right here, you see the default ending, but we might want it to have a different slide for every single video, and we can put that in here. Same thing for outros. We can also assign colors, our logo. As you saw in the previous section, we actually had our logo showing up on that pop-up interaction button. We can choose our branded font, our step appearance, all these different components of how we've branded our company. They are available here inside of Guidde's settings. So now you can rest assured that when you're sharing different Guidde's, so that whether internal or external, people are always remembering that they're interacting with your brand. I know we covered a lot in this video, and this is a new tool for us. It integrates so nicely with the things that we're building in no code. I hope you got a ton of value from it. If you have additional questions that we did not address, feel free to swing by our website. And in the meantime, keep on building.